All right, and this dressing is not too much of a thick dressing. You want it to be able to soak through the salad and get everything nicely marinated. All right. Okie dokie. So that's just another thing here. All right. So I'm gonna take a quick break. So while my my vinaigrette or my dressing is resting, my carrots are cooling, my chicken is also cooling out. So I'm gonna just do a little cleaning up, and by the time we return, we're gonna add the vinaigrette into our bowl and mix it in with our chicken, our carrots. We have some fresh tomatoes and the iceberg lettuce. If you have the regular lettuce, we can also use it. So see you shortly. All right, okay. So just a while ago, we had our carrot and the chicken cooling out. We cooked it earlier and we allow it to cool, all right? And I was placing some emphasis on iceberg lettuce. This is exactly what it looks like on the inside, right? It's layered, not as tightly packed as a cabbage, but it's much lighter, as you can see. And it is really nice lettuce, okay? So I'm gonna cut this up also, and I'm gonna put it into my salad. All right. All right, just some nice little strips. All right, so we're gonna put this in here. All right, I have some little tomatoes here. I just cut them in wedges, as you can see. I'm gonna add these in also. All right. And then our carrot and chicken, as you can see, nice colors. We're gonna add it in also. Okay? This is the dressing that we made a little earlier with using the fresh lime juice. We use a little oil, little pepper and celery, salt and pepper. And we're gonna just drizzle that nice creamy dressing over our salad. All right? And we're gonna give it a nice little toss so that you can get everything going through. Nicely marinated. And this, after you mix in your salad, before services, you can just put it in the fridge for just about 10, 15 minutes to get nice and chill. You know, let the flavors go inside nicely. And then you're good to go. You're good to go. All right, so if you take a closer look, look at how colorful this is. It's colorful, it's flavorful. It's different, all right? It's different from just grating carrot and shredding thing to make a little bit of coleslaw, you know, which is regular. I mean, I do enjoy it, but sometimes you just want to get out of the ordinary or the regular and try something that is a little bit more exotic and full of flavor. So we're gonna go right over here. Let me just clean this little board off. All right. I have no more use for these knives right now, so these can just take their place in the back. All right, all these bowls can go in the sink for washing. Okie dokie. All right. Okay, so that's it here. Okay. So a little earlier, while I took my little break, I just tried to put a little garnishes around, make it look pretty presentable. A little tomatoes, some zucchinis, etc. Some sticks of carrots. All right. And I'm just gonna take the salad now and put it in here. All right, so there goes. Ooh, nice colors, it's different. It's crispy and nice. You have a little chicken. You can also use fish, as I said earlier. You can use fish to make this also. You wanna get some of the greens? All right, look at this. It's starting to come to the top now, so you're starting to see your colors. All right. Mm-hmm. All right, nice little red, green. Have yellow, all different colors. Ah, I'm loving this, I tell you. This is what cooking with Carlos is all about. All right? Okay, so we're right up to the top now. Let me get a little green. Nice. Okay, chicken. So this is it. This is the moment that we all have been waiting for. All right, finding our colors, finding flavors, and also finding a fork. Finding a fork is always important when cooking with Carlos. So this is our beautiful salad where we add our chicken and all of the nice vegetables in it with a little dressing. And oh, I'm gonna try some of this now, I tell you. So, once again, I want to say thank you for cooking with Carlos. See you next time.